Hey everybody, welcome back to today's video. We are here at the Cycleland Speedway for the third time this season, points race number 3. You guys have been following us these recent weeks. We won last weekend here at the Cycleland Speedway, 48 open outlaw carts. We're gonna have another high car count tonight and I'm just pumped to be back. This place has kind of been tough for me through the years. We've struggled, we haven't had that many great finishes, and we've only ran a limited number of races with Factory QRC. Like I said, gonna be a full pit area tonight. We're hoping to repeat the success we had last weekend and I'm just excited. Great weather overall, it's gonna be a good day. Let's get into it, starting with qualifying. We pulled the number 10 pill tonight, so we're gonna go out and about group number 3. Here is a great look at the Cycleland Speedway located here in Chico, California. An absolutely beautiful racetrack, one of the best here on the West Coast, right alongside the Red Bluff Outlaws. Got a few fans who want to be in the video today. Brody, you've been in the video many times. Start off, you've had a great night at Cycleland a few times this season. How you doing today?
Good. I have my own YouTube channel now.
You have your own YouTube channel? Shout it out. What is it?
Brody Reynolds.
Brody Reynolds, okay. Now, moving over here, Cole Croft. Cole, you also have a YouTube channel, correct?
Yes,
you want to be in the video. What's your YouTube channel?
Cole Croft.
Cole Croft, make sure you guys go check out these two guys' channel. You also watch, they provide weekly content of Cycleland. Now, next here we got?
Landon.
Landon, and Landon, you've ran, this is what, one of your first races here?
This is my third race, and I have a YouTube channel as well.
Check out his YouTube channel.
On
what is it?
On Henry Brothers Racing.
Henry Brothers Racing, and last but not least, what's your name, buddy?
Brexies,
do you have a YouTube channel or no? No, not today? Okay. Make sure you guys check out these three guys' channels over here. Anyway, gonna be an exciting day here at Cycleland. Like I mentioned, we pulled the number 10 pill. Gonna roll out in group number 3. That'll be up next. We have driver's meeting, and then we'll get started with the night. Just got done with open division qualifying. We were group number 2, so a lot of cars still left to go. Felt like we laid down an all right lap. Track's only gonna get slicker. My only worry is though, at the end of qualifying, it might move up to the middle and the track will gain like probably 3 or 4 tenths. So hopefully our time holds. I believe we're sitting third quick after a few groups right now. Like I said, there's a very good possibility we could drop down depending on what the track does, but I felt like we laid down an all right lap. All right, so we ended up hanging on for a third place quick qualifying run. That's a great start to the night. To explain the format a little bit here at the Cycleland Speedway, the top 6 qualifiers in each division are automatically locked into the A main event. So no stress there, we're not gonna have to run a lower main. Now, the dash cars though don't have a chance at starting on the front row of the feature. So the heat race winners will set the top 4 in the A main event, and then the dash guys, the best they can start is 5th if you win the trophy dash, and the worst you can start is 10th. So we're gonna roll off second row outside for the trophy dash. It's key to try to get every car we can because that will help our starting position for the A main event. A little bit of a weird format, but it helps the qualifiers for points because we get so many more points. When you're not points racing though like us, it doesn't really matter. The best part to qualify is 7th or 8th. My teammate Landon Brooks went 7th quick. He's gonna be on the pole of a heat race. If he wins that, he will be on the pole of the feature, similar to kind of how we did it last week.
Thank you.
here is my race car. This may look a tad unusual. Just got done with the dash for the open class, and it looked pretty good from the GoPro footage. You guys probably didn't see anything too wrong with it. But one thing I noticed from being in the race car and turning laps was it seemed like my engine was about to blow up. After qualifying, you know, Jimmy, my car owner, he's like, you know, Landon's engine looks like it's ripping right now. He looked really good. Myself, it looked like my line was really good, but just the engine did not have the speed and possibly laying down. Then we went out for the trophy dash and it did not seem good at all. Had great speed, but it is just right on the end of blowing up, so we don't want to take any chances. Jimmy did go through and kind of look and see if he could find anything. We didn't, but like I said, it's just definitely at the end of its life and in need of a rebuild. So what we ended up doing, we threw the 18T on Kennedy's car. I'm gonna run this car for the open A main event, and then we're gonna take the wing off and put Kennedy's wing back on so she can run open intermediate. Shout out to her for letting me run her car. Here is her wing right here. Hopefully I can keep this thing in one piece. You know, we've been really, really fast here at Cycland. I fit right in it perfectly. The pedals were right where it needed to be. The seat fit fine. And overall, we should be good to go. Landon's car is right over here. It's all dialed up for the A main event. He's on the pole of tonight's open race. We are gonna be starting sixth. That will be up next. All right, rolling out for the A main event in Kennedy's car. We rolled up two positions there in the trophy dash, so we got great speed. Now we're in a completely different race car, so we're probably gonna take the first few laps pretty easy. Like I said, wanna keep this thing in one piece for Kennedy so she can run the OI, but this also is a good tune-up. Get to see how this engine runs compared to the one I've had on. The one I've had on the 18T, I've had on probably the last year and a half, so that's really the only thing I've ran besides a few select times. We're rolling off six here at Cycleland. The track is really, really good tonight. No rubber, at least as of right now. A good bottom, a good top. It's right up there by the fence, so we're really gonna just have to get up on the wheel and drive the thing. 25 laps though around the Cycleland Speedway. Hopefully you guys are tuned in on Fast Forward Media. If you're here for the vlog, thank you guys so much for watching. This should be an exciting one. Well, the racetrack was absolutely phenomenal tonight here at the Cycleland Speedway. The first two points races, it took rubber both nights right around the bottom, kind of just follow the leader. Tonight, they really reworked the racetrack after qualifying, didn't have to touch it much since then, and it ended up being prime. Check this out. A little bit of a bottom, not much down there, but a really nice top side. Many guys were just right up here by the wall. It didn't form right against the wall, but not far off of it. Typical Cycleland Speedway, really, really fast around the top side. Lots of slide jobs. Like I mentioned, not much of a bottom. I wish there was a little bit more grip down there, but that's really just how the racetrack formed for us tonight. We started sixth, worked our way up to fourth, and kind of just hung around there. About, man, eight laps into the race, I would say, my left front knuckle got rolled all the way forward, which really upset the handling of my race car. The fact that we were able to hold on for a top five with that really was, in my opinion, really amazing, because the car just became super unpredictable. Go in the corner, get tight, get loose, and I just wasn't sure what it was going to do. I do have to give another shout out though, like I said, to Kennedy Elledge for letting me run her car. She went out and ran the OI right after with it. That engine had a lot of speed. I knew mine wasn't going to last long after running the Trophy Dash and about blowing up across the line. Overall though, this track was super technical. Yes, you had to run it really, really hard around the top side. And also to mention, my teammate Landon Brooks got the win. Congratulations to him. The last two weekends, we had some really good finishes. You know, I won last weekend, he ran second. This weekend, he wins, I run fourth. Felt like we had a third place car there. You kind of saw Jesse Caldwell. He got loose, spun out right on the exit of four here. And I don't know how I missed him. I am not sure. It was just that much, it felt like. And then after that, since that held me up, I about stuffed it in the fence, just trying to miss, got in the fluff. And then I got slid down in one and two, and we went three wide down the back straightaway. About a lap there was just insane how we didn't all wreck. Anyway, like I mentioned, shout out to Low Morale and everyone at Cycleland. The racetrack was super fun tonight. I actually enjoyed running the top side, even though that's not really my style. We had a good consistent night. We'll be back at Cycleland a few more times this summer to have a lot more fun. Once again, thank you to Jimmy Elledge and everyone at Factory QRC, Durst Incorporated, Burris Racing Tires, Jet Fitness, and everyone else that helps out the QRC clan. Awesome for us to run up front with our Spitfire. If you're in need of any Outlaw kart stuff, check out QRC Karts in the description below. They had a phenomenal night tonight. Anyway, see you guys all in the next video. Thank you for tuning in. Deuces.